leadership. Leadership matters in a lot of ways. And I think the best way to describe leadership is who you are. Like, what do you do? What is your involvement? And how you pinpoint those things. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So, to me, that is something that's not really talked about as much. So, the purpose of the Voice of the Students is basically get unfiltered of what you do in Eastern Union County, as well as what you do within your involvement within Wingate. Events, whether that's fraternities, sororities, as well as athletes. Those things are things that is not talked about. So let's get into it. I'm going to start off with me first. I'm Aiden Howard, a leadership intern for the Voice of the Students. The CCG, also known as the Collaborative for the Common Good, also known as the Place to Be. Today we have a special guest, Jalen McNish.
What's good? I'm Jalen McNish, you know, representing the 919, Raleigh, North Carolina.
And that's what it's going to be, man. We're going to just basically dig in a little bit about who you are, your involvement as a leader, and what we should get from you as a leader. So first, I want to just know a little bit about you, like major, what do you do, and what is your plans after you graduate?
So, you know, I'm a psychology major. I started with plans after I graduated. So after I graduate, you know, I definitely plan to make some money because, you know, I'm tired of being a broke college student.
Okay.
You know, so, you know, I'm going to get a job, you know, work for about a year, kind of trying to figure out, deciding, you know, what I'm playing my last year, football in the fall, stuff like that. But the ultimate goal, too, like, even beyond that, would be, you know, I'm trying to attend grad school, get my master's in sports and performance psychology.
Okay.
But also, too, you know, coming in the fall, I'm going to have a business, you know, apparel company.
Okay.
That should be starting up around that time as
well. Okay. So let's start from the beginning. Mm-hmm. And, you know, a lot of people don't talk about, like, what brought you to Wingate?
So, yeah, so that's actually interesting. I'll be honest, you know, the one thing that brought me to Wingate was football. And I remember being in high school, I would get these emails from some school called Wingate. I'm like, who are these people? Like,
I can respect.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So, and it's kind of funny because I actually ended up, you know, I had a really good senior season. I ended up actually, you know, emailing the coaches here, and they were like, yeah, come on, you know, we have a spot for your team. So came in as a walk-on, you know, and basically just, you know, it was all she wrote from there.
Basically, history told itself.
Exactly.
So, and I think a lot of people don't go into that, like, that takes your own steps as well, trying to get into schools and the blessings of even Wingate accepting you to, you know, continue your education as well as the sports you love. So essentially, I heard back to your major is?
Psychology.
And what you're trying to do with it, like where is you trying to take that?
So, well, I'll start with this, you know, it's funny, I came in, started out as a bio major here at Wingate, and a lot of people who are bio majors understand how hard that is to do, you know, and play sports.
Right.
So, you know, later on down the line, and then also too, kind of, it was just like, man, you know, bio, I don't really see myself doing too much, really utilizing it as much as I really could.
Right.
And that's where I took a sports psychology class. Wasn't even a psychology major at the time, took a sports psychology class, and just like, in a sense, like, I guess fell in love with it in a way. You know, it was just so interesting to me, you know, like the mind to me, especially being a creative, the mind is such a beautiful, you know, concept, a beautiful thing, you know what I'm saying? How intricate it is, like, and taking that, basically being able to help other athletes as well.
Mm-hmm.
You know, not necessarily, a lot of people kind of have a few misconceptions about sport and performance, like college, thinking that we're basically like shrinks to athletes.
Okay.
But, which in a sense, you can look at it that way, but it's also too, in a sense, like helping athletes perform, you know, do this, what would they went to school to do, basically, you know what I'm saying, play sports.
Right.
You know, whether it be collegiate, professionally, high school, but basically compete at the highest level possible, you know, and really drag that mental aspect out of it.
And that's a good tie-in between the two, because essentially, like, we forget that sports is very competitive, education is very competitive, and you being a voice in all those, as well as a leader on the team to do those things is really hard.
Well,
and definitely we see that you brought some heat in
to
describe basically what you're doing with your business. So go a little more deep in that. Like, what is that?
What it is, you know, no limit. You know what I'm saying? Let me ask you this. What do you think of when you think of no limit?
If I'm be honest, it's no excuses what I can do. I have no limit to what I need to do or what I have to do to me.
Mm-hmm. Right. And essentially what that is, we're taking that concept, taking that frame, and we're turning it into a lifestyle.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? The brand No Limit is the full name. So what it is basically, really, I'm be honest with you, if you ask me description, there's no limit.
Okay.
You know, right now, I'm doing customs. You know, like I said, eventually it's going to get to the point where it's going to be apparel, you know, more so mainly like designer streetwear apparel. So like kind of like your brands like Santa Cruz, okay, 100 and stuff. But I've even like, I've wrote down a business plan. I've even like expanded beyond apparel, like, you know, okay, to reach other, you know, aspects in what we do. Because like I said, at the end of the day, there's no limit. So the business is going to represent, there's no limit to what we can do. You know what I'm saying? As humans.
Okay. So within that, within No Limit, within what you're doing, let's debrief, because essentially this hustle mentality, this aggressive to get your stuff out there and be heard, have you basically got things out to anybody in Wingate? Have anybody else?
So in a sense, I think right now, you know, I'm in the stages of and I was actually working on coming out with a like a little t-shirt launch, you know, around, okay, this time, but I actually decided to kind of dial it back some, only because the idea and the concept wasn't fully developed yet.
You know? Okay.
So, but as far as like getting other products out there, you know, I've had a lot of, you know, hype on campus over some customs. You know, I remember being in a game last fall and, you know, looking on the field, and I had majority of the team, a lot of the team wearing, you know, custom cleats by me.
That's dope.
Also, I'm having people, you know, hit me up. Like, I've had people hit me up in California, Texas.
So you worldwide.
I mean, not quite. That's the goal, though. You know what I'm saying? That's the goal.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Right? So, in a sense, I call this stage to plant my seed. You know what,
okay,
I'm saying? Right now, I'm establishing what No Limit is.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm working on my craft and getting some, you know, soft products out there. You know what I mean?
Okay. So, I like that the word what you said was plant the seed. You know, and that's similar to what the CCG does. We basically plant our seed in different places, such as Hardin Monroe. We plant our seed in Alien Adventures. We plant, mm-hmm, our seed with different events as well as things in Eastern Union County. And basically that is something that a leader must do. They basically must, mm-hmm, step out of their pocket to do those things, because essentially if you just say it but don't do it, it's just a dream.
Right, right.
But if you actually apply what you're trying to do in life, then people will listen and understand, mm-hmm, and see your vision, understand your vision as if,
right,
they made it. You know what I'm saying? So, and the point of this podcast and the point of you being here is leadership. And my question to you is, how does and what does leadership mean to you?
So, that's actually an interesting question. You know, something I never, you know, it's a question that you get all the time, but you never really sit and think about it.
Right.
To me, leadership is really just being able to, in my eyes, be able to be who you are. Say who you are and stand behind that, you know what I'm saying, no matter what.
Okay.
You feel me? Look at your best leaders. You
know, okay,
what I'm saying? Even you can look at Donald Trump. Not a lot of people like him, but there's one thing that you can say about him, is he is who he is.
And he's a leader. I mean?
And he's a leader.
Okay.
Look at people, Michael Jordan. Again, another guy, he is who he is. When you sit down and have a conversation with these people who are heads of country or heads of businesses, you know, I've been watching I've been doing a lot of research within the fashion, you know, and in apparel, and I've come across a lot of people like Sahale Benberry, who's one of the lead designers of Versace.
Okay.
And you talk to him, he is who he says he is. You
know? Right.
So that's one thing that, like, it, you know, that's definitely a quality, is just authenticness.
And people delude basically leadership in the aspect, because essentially, like, they forget the comparison between Kobe, mm-hmm, LeBron James, and Jordan, mm-hmm, and all their leader aspects. We have leaders such as Michael Jordan, and I know people are going to get on me about this, yeah, but Michael Jordan was a leader on the court.
Mm-hmm.
But then we have somebody like LeBron James, who is actually a leader on and off the court.
Right, right.
So it just depends who you look up to, yeah, or who you play a role in as your character. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But everybody has their different viewpoints on who they are and what they think. So moving forward from that, and we had like a brief conversation about it, but, mm-hmm, leadership on campus.
On campus.
So what is your leadership aspect on campus? I understand that we have the apparel, and that, mm-hmm, is some things that you're doing. But talk to us a little more about you being a leader as an athlete.
So as an athlete, you know, I mean, I think a lot of the younger, you know, guys kind of look up to me in the aspect of, you know, coming into college the way I came in. You know, mm-hmm, I came in as a walk-on. You know, coaches not really understand what I can do, both academically and off the field. You, mm-hmm, know, so I think me just being me and the way I carry myself, you know, as hard as I work, You know what I'm saying? On and off the field, that carries over, and then, like, people see that, people understand it. You know, it's weird, like, because it's like you put in, when you work hard, you know, you put in all this work, you know, doing what it is you're doing, and it's like, after a while, you get to this point where it's like, okay, like, I'm not getting any type of gratification from it. Like, is it actually working? Is it doing what it's supposed to do? Mm-hmm. And then you get people to come up to you and be like, yeah, bro, like, I just really admire, like, how hard you work. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Or you get that grade on the test, like, that you didn't think you was going to pass at all, and you ended up passing with flying colors. It's like, that's when you see that gratification. It's so, like, it feels good. So mm-hmm. I think people seeing that on campus, like, has in a sense put me in a leadership position. I personally don't think I'm a leader, mm-hmm. but I guess if you're looking from the outside in, you know, you could potentially say that's one of the, you know, characteristics that I carry.
So, and it's funny that you say that, like, mm-hmm. leaders don't know they're leaders. And that's crazy, because sometimes leaders step back on certain situations where they are a leader. And a lot of people don't see that, and basically tie that to back what you were saying about being a leader is, and I'm hit so with this one, is just, you know, what is your purpose in life? What is your purpose on the brand? What is your purpose as being an upcoming leader within the field? Like, what is your purpose of all that? What drives you to get up and say, get it done, gotta go, gotta move, let's do it?
That's an interesting question too, you know, like, what is your purpose question? Like, again, something that, you know, you think about, but you never truly find the answer to, you know what I'm saying? Like, until maybe it's too late.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So, I mean, personally, my purpose is, as of right now, you know, I don't necessarily know what my one true purpose is, because I feel like everybody has one. I have a few, smaller purposes that I feel like are pointing me, are saying, like, hey, bro, like, go this way, I'm about to show you your purpose. You know what I'm saying? I think that's what's going on right now. So mm-hmm. somewhere within the realm of, you know, my creative ability and you know, going to school for psychology mm-hmm. and, you know, even being athletically, you know, playing sports.
Okay.
You know, that those three things I feel like are, in a sense, this is the doorway into the house filled with my purpose. Okay. If that makes sense.
Hey, I ain't never thought about no analogy like that. I think you're going to say put the shoe fit in, it's going to be my purpose or something.
I had to take them off earth for that one, you know what I'm saying?
And that's what
no limit. No limit.
So, and the crazy thing about that is COVID. You know, COVID has basically synced a lot of people down, depression, but it also has brought a lot of people. And I'm wanting to speak for that, because basically during COVID, I found my purpose. And some mm-hmm. people think their purpose supposed to be that day.
Yeah.
But you find it within life randomly. It just clicks. And I think during COVID, it showed that I developed a skill that I knew I had, but didn't know I had.
Mm.
And that skill is just being more versatile within life, you know, mm-hmm. enjoying the simple things, nature, hiking.
Yeah.
And, you know, just being involved around people that give you energy, increase your aura. And that's things that you only can protect. So, and basically to strengthen that sentence is basically like, how do you get in touch with that? You know, how do you get in touch with mm-hmm. vibes, energy? How do you get in touch with just connecting with people?
So that's interesting. You know, it's funny because I feel like it seems like it sounds kind of weird. You're actually the first person to tell it, like, kind of disprove my theory. But, like, it's funny because, like, a lot of people say they seem to find their purpose during times of, like, their most, like, vulnerable selves.
Okay.
So, for instance, like, again, being with COVID, you know, it's been a tough year for a lot of people. You know, some people, I just use, they seem to have found their purpose in a sense mm-hmm. because they've been in a situation where they were so low. It's like, okay, what can get me out? What brings me joy out of the situation?
You know, right,
so
right.
Once you find that, again, like you said, for you as nature and hiking, and, you know, like, I feel like that kind of, then, again, the doorway into the house of your purpose, and that shows you what mm-hmm. your purpose is, you know what I'm saying? As far as just overall, like, for me, again, I haven't really found my purpose per se. Like, what was the question?
Which one? The purpose, or yeah. you just finding your inner self?
So, find my inner self. Okay, yeah. So, find my inner self, again, that's something that over the same situation, over quarantine, you know, a lot going on, being inside, mm-hmm. you know, with yourself a lot, helped me to find it. And that's the advice that I'll give to other people, too. If you really want to find who you truly are, what you truly like, the things that truly make you mad, the things that are truly, you know, you truly enjoy, and people are going to not like when I say this, but be by yourself. Not a lot of people aren't.
A lot of people do not like being by themselves. I think self-love is the first key to loving others.
Most definitely.
So if you're trying to find love from others, it's not always going to work. I mean, some people can be there and be a patch or a band-aid to things that are occurring in life. But at the end of the day, they have their problems and issues as well, or they have goals that they're trying to reach.
Right, right.
But once you can be able to stand out and be by yourself, then your self-love can spread to others. And again, like we said, energy. Your energy will just blow off to others naturally.
Indeed. And going to self, going off the self-love thing, too, like, at the end of the day, you know, you're Aiden. Mm-hmm. I'm Jalen. Right. Live your life, you know what I'm saying? Like, do what you want to do. If there's one day you just don't, you just want to stay in bed all day, stay in bed.
Right.
If you want to buy that pair of shoes, but like, do stuff that truly does make you happy, even if it's, whether it's material, whether it's not material. Mm-hmm. You know, again, not saying money buys happiness, but it does make a lot of things easier. You know what I'm saying? So,
hey, he said it first. I wasn't gonna say it, but
you know what I mean? I had to drop it. Had to leave Earth for that. You did.
No, but.
No,
you're right, dude. Like,
at the same time, I got put on game the other day. You know what I heard somebody say?
Okay.
When you get money, why spend your own money? Okay. Save your money. Spend other people's money.
And you know what else I heard? Yeah. This is what I heard from a man back in Cali. He said something to me that sticks to me to this day. He said, you know, right now you live life Monday through Sunday, all right? Mm-hmm. 7 days in a week, right? Why would you do that within life? You sacrifice 3 to 5 years, and you can have 6 Saturdays and 1 Sunday. Mm. So every day is a fulfillment.
Yeah.
Because basically we don't go into life saying like, okay, it's Monday, let's do this. We go into Monday like,
man.
Yeah,
Monday, I like Mondays, bro. Monday is like, because it's the start of the week, it's like, okay, it's a new week. I get to really start over, really, like, get into it. Dude.
Right.
Get to that bed, you know what I mean? Like, Mondays is like a, for me, and it's funny, I've been like that since I was a kid. Like, going to school on Mondays is just always different for me.
Yeah, I think Mondays is like my grinding out days.
Yeah.
As it goes down, everything just slow down. You're like... Okay, I guess we finna start this over, but I have a new task I need to hit.
Right, most definitely.
But I like I tell my friends, peers, and like I tell you, just like, every week have a goal. Mm-hmm. Whether it's that I'm gonna cook some eggs today, I ain't cooking last week, I'm gonna make a big breakfast, you know, but whatever it is, attack the day with a purpose. Mm-hmm. And that's why I say, what is your purpose? Because essentially, your purpose can be 1 day, 2 days, or it can be, finalized for every day.
Right, right.
But again, a purpose doesn't have to be always big. It can be small depending on how you look at it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So, and to basically chew this out and start, end it off on the right thing is basically, what's coming next for you, man?
Coming next, man. Shoot, that's something everybody's gonna have to wait and see.
Okay.
Out, man. So, I got a lot of things planned. I really do, you know what I'm saying? Right now, you know, I'm setting everything up, you know, a goal at a time.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Writing goals down, setting them up a goal at a time, and basically gave myself a deadline.
Okay.
You know, by 2022, January 1st, 2022, these are the things I want to have that are done.
Right.
You know, as far as for me personally, I have quite a few things that are next, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Depending on when they are actually accomplished.
Okay.
There's no set date, but it's between now and 2022. As far as No Limit as a brand, we're doing a lot right now, you know what I'm saying? We're doing a whole lot of, like, just the business aspect of it.
Right,
getting
right.
set up, you know, being able to go and present this until, you know, once it gets big enough, because it will get big.
It will be big.
I'm going to say that today on this show. No Limit Customs is going to be big.
But it started with this. You're going to be big, because essentially, indeed. Like, it's not going to grow unless you grow.
Right, indeed.
You know what I'm saying?
So, and it's funny you said, because a lot of the things that I do have personally for myself are more so things that I feel like are helping me grow, mm-hmm. be more comfortable with myself as a person.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Again, because essentially, like, the brand represents who, not just me, but who we are as humans.
Exactly. You know what I
mean? That's why the imagery within the brand, the astronaut, the aliens are all so prominent throughout, you know?
Because mm-hmm.
that's one thing that you will see a lot with throughout No Limit is that usage or that metaphor of the alien, the astronaut. You know, being mm-hmm. Mars, Venus.
Yeah.
So,
and then just to hit home is just basically is like, I understand, like you said earlier, we human.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So, being human, I know you have a few things you want to accomplish before you graduate. And I know you finna hit home this semester, end of the semester, and basically knock off. So is there anything that's left or anything that you have done, accomplished off your bucket list with Wingate?
It's funny, you know, coming into college, I was a lot different person.
Okay.
A lot different person. I was a lot more, not a lot less comfortable with myself, you know. And I honestly will say, you know, these last 4 years have definitely been, it's definitely been a college experience.
Okay.
I've experienced a lot of new things, you know. But it has opened my eyes up, you know, as far as, like, right now, my main thing right now is just to graduate.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? That's the first step in everything. Finish strong. You know, finish. Then once that happens, you know, makes things next. Okay, now, okay, boom, get a job. Got a job. Okay, start making money. You know, put some away. Start buying supplies for, you know, no limit.
Okay.
Like, those are really, like, the main things as far as the very near future, you know. So...
And I like that. And anything else you want to say to the audience before you go?
Man, not necessarily, man. That's
give them one of your fine dime quotes to end off.
I got to give them something. Got to take them off Earth one more
gotta
time.
Got to take one more time. Take them Pluto. Take them Pluto. One time.
Okay, I'll say this. You know, Black Lives, you know, I got to give a shout out Black Lives Matter and whatnot, man. But I'm going to just say this, man. You know, my whole concept on it is the one thing that makes all humans the same. Mm-hmm. Is that we are different, you know what I mean? So I feel like I'm one of those guys, you know, we should just, the no hypothesis theory, you know, we should all love everybody until somebody gives me a reason not to.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? The one reason we all, the one thing we all have in common is that we're all different, you know what I'm saying? Once we learn these differences, learn the difference, not just see what the differences are, learn the difference, understand them. You know, even if you don't understand, learn the differences, know that, you know, some people the way they are, you know, then we can be a lot more accepting of each other.
All right. And that's a good way to hit home, basically just loving one another, accept one another, and try to understand one another to make the world one.
Most definitely.
You know what I'm saying? So, and that's a good way to end it. Like I said, thank you for so much for coming out, giving us a little introduction to the shoes, who you are, No Limit Customs. Appreciate you, gentlemen, this. I am Aiden Howard, a student intern for the Collaborative for the Common Good, also known as the CCG, also known as the place to be. Tune in as we have more upcoming guests as well as more things within the CCG and also the voice of the students. And like I said, we're out.
Yes, sir.
You did it.
Oh,
it was good. I liked it. It was very interesting. It was.